And I've long said that we have to get into brinksmanship till where the sweat pops out on people's foreheads and they really start to worry.
And we thought we had such an arrangement with the Speaker of the House, who showed interest in it, Mr. Boehner. And then he went back to his caucus, and he had to yield to the most strident voices in his party. And they played brinksmanship with the full faith and credit of the United States.
And the Tea Party hobbits could return to Middle Earth, having defeated Mordor.
Let's look at the history of this. The fact of the matter is that this is essentially a Tea Party downgrade. The Tea Party brought us to the brink of a default.
Christine, first of all, why did S&P do this?
Because America faces an uncertain financial future, and the only certainty is that there's acrimony in Washington and an inability, it seems, on the surface for these problems to be solved in a meaningful way. S&P going out of its way to keep pointing out the brinksmanship in Washington as a hurdle or a roadblock against real reform.